Over the years, stadiums with air-supported roofs have suffered severe snow damage. And one by one, they've either been torn down, had their roofs replaced, or simply been abandoned. The 35-year-old Carrier Dome here in Syracuse is the last roof standing. Keeping this inflatable roof standing is priority number one for the stadium's maintenance engineers. In the freezing rain, this is no job for the faint-hearted.
Oh my God.
Can come on all the way out.
Can I walk on there?
Yep, come on out.
This is literally like on a trampoline. And when you think about what's down there, just
160 feet.
So what's crazy, guys, is underneath here, we're just being held up by air.
Just air.
Yeah, air and a piece of material as thin as a t-shirt.
When a snowstorm hits, up to 30 workers like Brandon and Justin are sent up to try and stop the snow from settling with nothing but hoses spraying hot water.
We start in the center of the roof in the most vital section, because if that starts to invert and go the other way, essentially the roof is going to start to come down.
That's exactly what happened to the Minneapolis Metrodome in 2010. That the Carrier Dome is still standing is largely thanks to the hard work done by these brave workers, as well as the stadium's managing director, Pete Sala.
How much weight actually goes on the roof before it sort of would start to collapse?
When we get into the 15, 16, 17-inch snowstorms that come quickly, the snow has a very, very high water content.
Sure.
Once you get above that 12 to 15-inch mark, the roof, you'll start seeing the roof coming down on its own.
So where are the real trouble spots for you?
Right here in the center is the worst part. There's 36 diamond panels up here that are roughly about 50 by 50 in shape.
Yeah.
And, you know, the bulk of the weight of the roof is in that center of the roof.
Does that keep you awake at night? Does it worry you?
There's many, many sleepless nights. It's tough. It's a 24-hour, 7-day-a-week job.